already we discussed and we learned clearly a set of rules that was given by IUPAC. What is meant by IUPAC? What is meant by IUPAC? What is meant by IUPAC? You can give the reply. International Union for Pure and Applied Chemistry. So they given a set of rules, and based on that rules, we can assign the nomenclature to the different compounds. See, we need to assign it because worldwide we have some millions of chemical compounds are there. So if we need to identify it, we need to know its name. See, even in a classroom, if you want to know each other, definitely we need to know the names. If we want to call, how we can call? By using their name. The same way, if you want to know about it, we need to know its name. So this name was given by whom? And IUPAC, and it was based on some set of rules. Okay, now we'll see here the first example is, see, we'll see how we got butane 1 amine. See, we know that the basic rule, what exactly we have? Primary, what exactly? First we have root word. To this, what exactly we have? Primary suffix and secondary suffix, right? So root word will tell us what? Number of carbons. It will tell us about number of carbons. And primary suffix will tell us whether it is saturated or unsaturated. That means whether it is double bonded, single bonded, or triple bonded. Or even it can tell us in other way we can tell whether it is, we can give the primary suffixes are like ane, ene, ine. And secondary suffix, it will tell us about functional group. It will tell us about functional group. And these are called suffixes. And before to this, we will have prefix. What are the two prefixes we have? One is primary prefix and secondary prefix. Primary prefix will tell us about whether it is alicyclic or cyclic. If it is cyclic, we can assign it as cyclo, right? And secondary prefix, it will even tell us about branching. It will tell us about branching and some of the functional groups like halogens as well as nitro group will be there in secondary prefix. So based on the previous knowledge, now today we will discuss these examples, right? So the first example, what we have, this is the first example. So what is the first rule that we have to do? We need to check whether there is a functional group or not. First, we need to find out whether there is a functional group or not. Yes, we have a functional group. What is that functional group? NH2. And we know very well, when there is only one functional group, obviously it becomes under suffix, right? So what is this functional group? Amine. So at the end, what we have to write? Amine. At the end, what we have to write? Amine. It will come under what? Secondary suffix, right? So next, what we have to do? We need to see in such a way that we need to assign the numbering in such a way that carbon which attaches to the functional group must have get the highest priority. That means it has to get a lowest number. And here we are not worrying about long chain and all, because here we will worry about only functional group. See, highest priority will be given to a functional group. So here this functional group attached to carbon is this. So obviously this will be numbered as 1. And this is 2. Second carbon, third carbon, and fourth. So how many carbons we have here? 4. When we have a 4 carbons, what is the root word? What is the root word exactly?
Butane.
What is the root word? Bute. Exactly. The root word is bute. And is there any double bonds here?
No, sir.
Exactly, Shirisha. Is there any double bonds? So what we have to put here? Ane. What is the primary suffix? Ane. Primary suffix is ane. And whenever there is a functional group, what exactly we have to do? We need to replace. E will be replaced by that functional group's suffix name. right? Here, what is the suffix name? Ami. As functional group, we have Ami. So we have to put E replaced by Ami. And this Ami is present at which position? First position. So I'll replace this E and hyphen at first position. What is there? Ami. So, or else we can write 1-butanamine. This also correct. And even we can write butane 1-amine. Did you all understand?
Yes, sir.
Did you all understand? Yes. Right. Now we'll go for the second example. This is, and we can call it as a primary amine. So, what is meant by primary amine? See, our functional group is nitrogen. And which attaches to only one carbon, then we can call it as primary amine. See, if you see this example, this second example, if you see, in second example, our nitrogen, see, this is nitrogen, this is functional group, it is attached to, this is one carbon, this is another carbon. It is attached to two other carbons. So we can call it as secondary amine. And the third one is what? Tertiary amine. What is meant by tertiary amine? See, this is the third one example. This is, we can say, third example. Here in third example, we can say our nitrogen attached with how many carbons? 1, 2, and 3. So we can call it as tertiary amine. And even in another way also we can tell, here nitrogen is attached to 2 hydrogens. So we can say it is primary amine. Here it is attached to only 1 hydrogen. So we can say it is secondary. I mean, here nitrogen is not attached with any hydrogen. Then we can say it as tertiary amine. We can say it is tertiary amine. But attaching with carbon is more proper. So we can say here nitrogen can attach with, here it is attaching with 3 other carbons. So we can call it as tertiary amine. We can call it as tertiary amine. Right. So this is the basic difference between primary amine, secondary amine, tertiary amine. And I told you very clearly in grade 12, in amines lesson, definitely there will be a question in board exam on nomenclature of these amines, because generally the students, they will confuse about, sir, what is this N-methyl and N-dimethyl. In such cases, they will confuse. So that is the reason, to avoid that confuse, we need to understand it very carefully, and here concept is very, very important. Right, so I think you all understood this first example. So now we will talk about, and we will just go through second example. What is that second example is, see, anyway, you need to practice lot of examples. The examples are there in other slides. So here already I given the names to, for our better understanding, already I given names. Now we will check it out, the second example, and slowly one by one, we'll complete all these functional groups. Then we can go for benzene compounds nomenclature. Okay, aromatic nomenclature we'll see there. And now see here, again, what is our functional group? The first criteria is, yes, functional group is there. Now, functional group, it is attached to 2 carbons, but out of that, out of 2 chains, here, this chain. So if you see, this is one chain and this is another chain. So this chain consists of more number of carbons, and we know the rule, longest chain, that means the chain which consists more number of carbons will be parent chain. That can be taken as parent chain. So here we can consider it as, see here 1, 2, 3, and here only one is there. Here one is there and here 1, 2, 3. So we can consider these 3 as a parent chain, right? So now just try to understand here, and we know very well, first we will write root word. What will be the root word here? What will be the root word here? How many carbons are there? Root word will tell us about number of carbons. Root word tell us about number of carbons. Here, how many number of carbons we have? 3. When we have 3, obviously, what we can call, what is the root word? Pro. What is the root word? Pro. And what is the primary suffix? Should we write N, E, I? Which one will be the correct?
N, sir.
n because only singly one. So we will write, and we know very well it is amine group. NH means amine group. So as it is amine group, so E will be replaced with what? Amine. And where it is present? At first position. Because carbon which attached to the functional group, that can be considered as first carbon. So that is the reason. That must be given lowest numbering, or we can say highest priority. So propane, 1-amine. But here, one more CH3 is attached to the nitrogen. So as when there is only one carbon, what we have to call? Methyl. As it is, we know that it is what exactly here it is? CH3. As CH3 here, what we have to call when it is in prefix, we need to call it as methyl. We need to call it as methyl. And to what it is attached? Nitrogen. So that is the reason we will write N-methyl-propane-1-amine. Am I clear to everyone? Am I clear? Am I clear? Yes. Yes. Right. Now we'll go for the third example. What is the third example? We'll see. So with this, we came to know very clearly that if methyl group or ethyl group or any alkyl group, if it is attached to other side of nitrogen, then we need to give or we need to assign N. We need to assign letter N. See, we can see the next one, third example, see here. Now check the chains around the nitrogen. See this side, how many are there? Three carbons. And here, only one carbon. Here, another one, only one carbon is there. So out of this can be taken as what? Longest chain. How many carbons are there here? Three. As we have a three, what will be the root word? Pro. And as we have only what? Exactly. What we have? Only single bonds. So primary suffix will be A. And E will be replaced by what? One. And because at first position, what is there? Amine. And next, around the nitrogen, what is there? Two methyl groups are there. Two methyl groups are there. So that is the reason what we have to call it as we have a methyls. How many methyls are there? Two. So what we have to, prefix we have to give to that methyl? Di. So dimethyl. And these dimethyls to attach it to what? Nitrogen. So in prefix we have to write N, N dimethyl propanamine or propane-1-amine. Propane-1-amine. Am I clear? Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Right. So next one. The next one, if you see, will you try this? This fourth example. Can you try this? Please try. So anyway, answer is there. But still, you can try it. See, the first criteria. First criteria. What is the first criteria? We have to see. What is the first criteria we have to see? Exactly. What is that? What is the first criteria? And double bond is also there, and amine is also there. But out of right, out of OH, and alcohol and any. To whom we have to give first priority? Alcohol. So alcohol attached to carbon will have highest priority. So numbering must be start from carbon which attached to the highest prioritized functional group. That is OH. So this is one first carbon, second carbon, third, and the longest chain we have to check, right? Fourth carbon. Right. See, the first, before writing the name, we need to understand. So what are the things that we have here in the whole compound? We have OL as it is alcohol, and we have E as we know that it consists of double bond, and we have amine. What is this amine? As it consists of one methyl, so we can call it as methyl amine. But if there is only one functional group, then we can call it as methyl amine. But it is also a substituent, right? It comes under it. Before it was, in the previous examples, it was the suffix. Now it is prefix because alcohol is having highest priority than amine. So suffix place will be taken by alcohol, and prefix in the prefix, this substituent, now this can be called as substituent, right? So this can be comes under, and it will be in the place of prefix, right? Now we know it is methyl amino. It will be replaced when it comes to the prefix, right? So, and this methyl amino, in which position it is there? In which position it is there? 1, 2, 3. So 3 methyl amino, because a substituent is having still other substituents, then we will put it in parentheses, right? Brackets. So 3 methyl amino. And what is the root word better here? How many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So what is the root word? S. What is the root word? Yes, exactly. Bute. And at what position we have double bond? Primary suffix. Second position. Yes, exactly. Cymethane. Yes. Yes, exactly. Correct. Right. Yes. Bute to E. And E will be replaced by what functional group? What is the functional group here? Alcohol. So what we have to write? OL. And where exactly it is present? At first place. So E will be replaced by 1-OL. 1-OL. Did you all understand? Did you all understand? Right. Even we can write. Bute 2E-1-OL. But as we have a many functional groups, we need to mention. Exactly. Right. Next. So we'll go for other examples and see this this example. Please try to do this example. Please try to do this example. See, whenever, even though it is a functional group, say for example, aldehyde, ketone, carboxylic acid, anhydride, ester, you need to see the carbon, you need to calculate that carbon also, you need to include that functional group's carbon in the longest chain, right? See, generally students will confuse, sir, it is functional group, it is also functional group, so now longest chain is only this, sir. Then you will get what? Your root word will become pro. That is wrong. So even carbon present in the functional group also, you need to calculate it. You need to consider that carbon in the parent chain. So now how many carbons we have? How many carbons we have here? Either side it is correct only. Either side if you take it is correct only. Right? Exactly. Five carbons we have. Five carbons we have. Now, when we have a 5 carbons, what is the root word? What is the root word? Pent. Exactly. Pent. And is there any, what is the primary suffix here? What is the primary suffix? Is there any double, triple bonds? No. So only single bond. So what exactly it will? What we have to write? What we have to write in place of exactly yane, pentane, and E will be replaced by what? Oic acid. What is that? Oic acid. So simply we can write pentadioic acid because two oic acids are there. That is the reason. Pentadioic acid. So even if you will write pent 1,5-dioic acid also you can. Okay, dioic acid. Exactly. Everyone are correct. Right now we can go for other examples. Now we can go other examples. Here it is also the same kind. Just now we discussed. Here we have a three oxygen. See here. How many are there? 1, 2, 3. Right? Here we can't add all these things in the because as we are saying tricarboxylic acid. It is not complete IUPAC name. Right? When it is complete IUPAC name, what we will write? We have to write trioic acid. Right? When you write common name, we can write propane 1, 2, 3 tricarboxylic acid. When we are hearing that word tricarboxylic acid, we have to understand that there is a COOH. How many COOHs are there? Tri. Tri means 3. And what is the root word? Pro. So each carbon is attached with one carboxylic acid. Each carbon is attached with one carboxylic acid. In that way, same, please try to solve all these examples. Okay. Try to solve all these examples. Okay. Right. Do one thing. Try to do that example. See, what is this functional group beta? C double bond O NH2. What is this functional group? Amide. So E will be replaced by what? Amide. E will be replaced by amide. E will be replaced by amide. Right? Now, what is the highest chain here? What is the parent chain? 1, 2, 3. What is the root word? I'm writing here. What is the root word? Yes, pro. Pro. And what is that? What is the primary suffix? Anein. What is the primary suffix? Is there any double bonds? Double bonds are not there between carbon and carbon. Of course, it is there between carbon and oxygen, but that we will not consider. Don't confuse over there. Right? Many of you will have a sir. Double bond is there, no, sir. It is between carbon and oxygen. But I am talking about the see, whenever if you want to write in or I, see, double and triple bond must be exist between the carbon, not between any other atoms, like carbon and other hetero atoms. Right? So here there is no double bonds and triple bonds between carbon and carbon. So obviously it is what? A. Obviously it is propane. And E will be replaced by what? Amide. E will be replaced by amide. So what is this? Propanamide. What is this? Propanamide. What is this? Propanamide. Did you all understand? See the last example of the amide we will see today. What is that? See here. Example. What is the example here? This is the example. And here first what we have to see? Yes, what is the functional group? This is the functional group. What is this functional group? C double bond ONH. What is this? What is this functional group? What is this functional group? Amide. What is this functional group? Amide, exactly. It is amide. Right? So in this functional group amide, along with the functional group carbon also we need to consider in the long chain and give the numbering from there, and 1, 2, 3, 4, right? So how many carbons we have? 4. So as we have 4, what is the root word? Butte, right? And we know that all single bonds are there. Exactly, Harika. What is the, all single bonds are there? So what we can call it as ane. Primary suffix is ane, and e will be replaced by what? As we have amide, e will be replaced by butanamide, and methyl group is attached to what? Nitrogen. So that is the reason what methyl group attached to the nitrogen. It comes under prefix, and we have to write N-methyl butanamide. In common nomenclature, we even call butyramide also we can call. But it is most proper to learn IUPAC nomenclature. Of course, we need to even know some of the common nomenclature, that is that common names, that anyway, whenever it is required, I tell you. Okay, right. Now we have other example here, right? See, I'm just making you to learn, and we are practicing at least 2 to 3 examples on each functional group, right? So already I have sent this PPT to you. You just practice the remaining, whatever the examples are there, whatever the examples are there, please practice. See, out of 4, we are doing at least 2 to 3. And the remaining one, you have to practice on your own. Still, if you have any doubts on that particular example, you are allowed to ask me at any time. You just post that in our Telegram channel. We will rectify your problem. We'll clear your doubts. Feel free to ask any of your doubts. Okay? CL. What is this COCl? Is this? I already told you, this is a derivative of what? Carboxylic acid. When OH is replaced by halide, then what is this? We have to call it as OL chloride. What we can say, suffix will be there, OL chloride. So who will be replaced? E will be replaced by OL chloride, right? Carbonyl halides. So alkanyl chloride, we can call it as alkanyl. What is meant by alkanyl here? It depends on the number of carbons. As we 1, 2, 3. As we have 3 carbons here, what is our root word? Pro. And as we have a single bond, what we call propane, primary suffix is ane, and E will be replaced by what, beta? OL chloride. So OL chloride. As we have Cl, if we have a bromide, it will be OYL bromide. We have to add at the end. It will be placed in the secondary suffix. As it is a functional group, it will be in secondary functional group. Am I clear? Am I clear, or do you have any doubts? Yes, thank you. Chalo, we'll go for the next topic. See, as we know very well, whenever we have a cyclic compound, the primary suffix is what? Cyclo. Sorry, primary prefix is what? Cyclo. Primary prefix is cyclo. So how many number of carbons we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we know that it is cyclohexane. Cyclohexane. And what is the functional group here? We have carbonyl chloride. Carbonyl chloride. That exactly we need to write here. Then what it will become? Cyclohexane carbonyl chloride. Carbonyl chloride. Carbonyl chloride. Right. See the next example. So you will have a little bit confusion here, but try to understand this. And it is very, very important also. See here, how many functional groups we have? Three functional groups, and along with the double bond also can be. Of course, it is not functional group, but when there is nothing else, we can give a priority to the double bond. But here, many are there. So out of that, the functional first one is acid chloride. We have the first functional group, and next is what? Aldehyde and OH. So as if you give first priority, then what will happen? If the numbering will go from, if numbering will go anti-clockwise, then what will happen? 1 plus, 2 plus, this will become 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, if you go clockwise, anti-clockwise, it is giving same. As it is giving same or not, once we will count it, right? 1 plus, 2 plus, 4 plus, 6. Total, what is the lowest angle we have to, I'm just checking lowest angle, right? 1 plus 2, 3, 7 plus 6, how much? 13. So if you go this way, what is this? 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 6, how much? 3 plus 3, 6, 6 plus 6, 2. So this way is more proper, clockwise is more proper than anti-clockwise. Right, and even aldehyde is right clockwise is more proper. See here, so now when aldehyde comes under a substituent, when it is a substituent, when it is not a functional group, when other functional group is more periodized than this, then this will comes under what? Prefix. And when carbonyl, when carbonyl, when it is, when car, when aldehyde is there, generally suffix will be al, but when comes under prefix, what is that? What we have to write? Formyl. In prefix it will be called as formyl, and this formyl is at what position? Second position. And next we have, if it is suffix, we will write what? Ol. But when it is in prefix, what we will write? Hydroxy. Already we discussed this. What is this? Hydroxy. So second position we have formyl, sixth position we have hydroxy, and primary prefix is cyclo. And we know that how many carbons are there? Six. How many carbons? Six. And at third position, what is there? E. You don't confuse here. Right, now check the number so you will not confuse. Right, hex, at third position what is there? E, right? And it is out of fluoride. Did you all understand? Did you all understand, or should I repeat again? Yes. Right. See, as we have how many functional groups here? We have a three main functional groups. Out of that, one will be the highest periodized group is there. That is the acid chloride, or we can say carbonyl chloride. It is carbonyl chloride. So as it is functional group, as it is main functional group, it will come under, it will be there, it will occupy the position of secondary suffix. And remaining all functional groups can be what? They can be comes under, they will not be functional groups now. Right? They will be one of the same. It is a sub-functional group. We can call it as a sub-functional group. So as it is a sub-functional group, it will comes under prefix. Right, when OH is a functional group, if only OH will be there, then suffix, it will come under suffix, and in suffix we will write OL. But when it is occupied this prefix, OL can be considered as hydroxy, right? Hydroxy. Aldehyde can be considered as formyl. So in second position we have formyl, in sixth position we have what? Hydroxy. And we know that it is cyclohexene, and E means double bond. So definitely we need to give a numbering to the double bond. And where exactly it is there? In triple bond, sorry, in third position. Double bond is present at third position. What is, so that is the reason cyclohexa-3-E, and this is the main functional group. That is the reason it will comes under suffix. So what we have to write? We need to add carbonyl chloride. So four, the name is 2-formyl-6-hydroxycyclohexa, and third position ene is there, double bond is there. That is the reason 3-ene carbonyl chloride. I think now you understood. Am I clear? Am I clear to everyone? Exactly. Right. So in the same way, please try to do all these things and you just practice at home, and already I have sent this PPT to you. Just go through it and practice it. Right. So this is one of the example, and read the IUPAC nomenclature and see here. Generally, what we will see, generally we will write like this, C double bond OOH. But if you write like that, or if you write like this also same, this is what? Carboxylic acid, C double bond OOH. This is carboxylic acid. Carboxylic acid. From there, you need to start giving numbering, because highest priority group is carboxylic acid. So give numbering. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? 7, 8. At 8, so 8 carbons are there. So obviously it is oct. It is oct. It is oct. Right? And at oct, and what we have to write? Octane, generally, because there is no double bonds. Octane, and E will be replaced by what? As we have a functional group carboxylic acid, E will be replaced by what? Exactly. What is that? Correct. Still others. What? E will be replaced by what? E will be replaced by OIC acid. What is that? OIC acid. Octanoic acid. And see, at fifth position we have ethyl group, two carbons are there. At fourth position we have keto, but out of E and K, which will comes first according to alphabetical order? E. So fifth position we have ethyl hyphen, fourth position we have keto octanoic acid. Octanoic acid. See, the first one is wrong because he said hydroxy. So there is no OH, so it is not hydroxy. And second one, carboxy ethyl 3-hexyketone. No, because there is no carboxy. So that is also wrong. And third one is also wrong because he said it is only propanoic acid, but it is number of carbon atoms are how many here? 8. So obviously the answer is D. In that way, please try to check it out. This also, this example also, please go through it. Okay, these examples, please go through it. Right, now we'll go for the naming of aromatic compounds. Naming of aromatic compounds. And of course, what is aromaticity and all, we will discuss in the next slides. Okay, there generally we need to talk about Kukel's rule. Okay, 4n plus 2 pi electric, 4n plus 2 pi electrons will be there, 4n plus pi electrons will be there. There we have to talk about all these things, and based on that, and whether it is a planar structure, non-planar structure, right? Based on some sort of rules, we will assign it whether it is a aromatic, non-aromatic, anti-aromatic. It is also very, very important question, even for your competitive exams also. So we will learn that also. That is Hooten's rule will be there. And we will discuss that in the other slides. Right now, we will discuss the nomenclature of these aromatic compounds. Right, then we'll try to give the naming. Okay, generally, what is meant by aromatic? I already told you, aroma means it is a pleasant smell actually. Right, and mostly benzene. mostly benzene type compounds. They will come under aromatic compounds. Again, aromatic compounds are two types, benzenoid compounds and non-benzenoid compounds, that we will discuss slowly in the next slides. Right now we'll see the aromatic compounds are cyclic compounds which contain one or more benzene type rings. Benzene is the simplest hydrocarbon of aromatic series. And what is benzene? See, this is benzene. So the name, what is the alphabet name of this? What is the alphabet name of this? How many carbons are there here? We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we know that it is cyclic structure. So what we will write? Cyclohex. And how many triene are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Or else, wait a minute. I'll write in a proper way. See, anyway, if it is there, no, we'll write C. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. As we know that, it is what? Cyclo, closed, source. And how many carbons are there? Root word. A. How many is it? E, A or I? E. How many enes are there? How many double bonds are there? 3. So it is obviously triene. So what are the positions? 1 comma, 3 comma, exactly 5. 5 triene. Triene. Cyclohexa, 1 comma, 3 comma, 5. Triene. That exactly. This is IUPAC name, but generally we can call it as benzene. Did you ever find this type of structure in our school? In our school, generally in our school, so many are there. Even in front of your home also, it will be present. Yes, exactly. What is that? Parking tiles. Generally, parking tiles are hexagonal shape only, no? Right? Alright. So now, so these are the aromatic compounds, and when we are giving nomenclature here, see if there is only one substituent. And numbering starts from there only. See, for example, chlorine here. So we have to start from here only. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And if it starts from here, then we will start from here only. So wherever functional group attached from that carbon only, we'll give the numbering. But if it is disubstituted, then these two groups are called ortho. These two groups are called metaposition, and exact to this is called para. So ortho will be denoted with O, meta will be denoted with M, para will be denoted with P. Right? Ortho, meta, para. Ortho, meta, para. Right? So now, can you please tell me what is this? Is this ortho, meta, para? Or none of the above? Oh my god, yes, exactly, exactly. But is that is 100% wrong answer. That is the reason I told you very clearly it must be disubstituted, and it is only one substituted, it is monosubstituted, then obviously it will be one, it starts with one. It is not ortho, it is not para, it is not meta. With reference to any group, we can call 1 comma 2 position is called ortho, 1 comma 3 position is called meta, 1 comma 4 position is called para. So when we can say ortho, meta, para, already one substituent is there, and if you go for second substituent, disubstituent, with respect to the first substituent, we can call these positions are ortho, meta and para. Did you now understand? Did you now understand? Yes. Yes. Okay. So generally, this every year, the students definitely they will do this mistake. This is the reason wantedly I made you to do that wrong thing. And now you understood very clearly. So you will never ever do such mistakes again. Okay, so what is this? Now we know. Now you tell me, is this ortho position or para position? See, ortho, para, meta will be present when there is two substituents are there, then only we can say, when there is disubstituent, then only we can say whether it is ortho, meta, para, exactly in the shape, correct. So this is ortho, this is 1, 3, meta, exactly, everyone is doing good, right. And what is this 1, 4?
Para.
1, 4 is para. And we know that this is benzene. Exactly. This is benzene. At one position and two position, what exactly is there? Methyl groups are there. So how many methyl groups are there? Two. When two methyl groups are there, what will be the prefix we will give to methyl in front of that? When two are there, di. So where it is exactly present? Yes, exactly. So 1, 2 dimethyl benzene. 1, 2 dimethyl benzene. 1, 3 dimethyl benzene. 1, 4 dimethyl benzene. See, and then when you come for the when we are considering common nomenclature CH3, when two CH3s, when two methyl groups present on benzene, generally we will call it as xylene. What is that? Xylene. As it present in ortho position, we can call orthoxylene, metaxylene, paraxylene. If OHs are there, we can call catechol, and that is the difference. Now next, I think in the next slides it will be there. Right? Orthoxylene, metaxylene, paraxylene. What is, see, if only one CH3 is there, what is the common name of this? This can be called as methyl benzene, and this can be called as even toline. What is toline? When only one methyl group present on the benzene, we can call it as toline. What is that? Toline. When on benzene, only one H2 is present, what is the common name? Aniline. What is this? Aniline. Okay? Aniline. What is this? Aniline. Okay? Aniline. Right. Now we'll see. This is very, very important. This will be very, very important because this cumin, we have to, even this can be seen in alcohol lesson in grade 12. There we will prepare ethers. There we can prepare some ethers. What is ethers? ROR. Yesterday we discussed ethers. Alkoxy alkane. Ethoxy ethane. Ethoxy ethane. Propoxy ethane. Yesterday we discussed, right? So CH3, CH3. Generally, what we can call isopropyl benzene. Sir, why we can call isopropyl? I already told you. See, if you write like this, then what is this? Something Y shape is there, right here. So CH3, CH, and it attaches to the benzene. So we know this group is called isopropyl. And this isopropyl attached to what? Who is attached to this? Benzene. So isopropyl benzene. But the common name for it is cumene. You have to remember this, very, very, very important. All these are very, very important. I'll tell you where exactly it will come also. Right? Cumene. This will be helpful in your ethers lesson. There we will prepare some sort of ether from the cumene. Okay? From cumene. So this is cumene. And what is this? What we can call? We know this is ethene, right? Ethene. What is ethene? CH2 double bond CH2. What is the root word? Eth. When double bond is there, what we will write? E. So here ethene, and there is a substituent. What is the substituent? Benzene group is substituted. When benzene group is a substituent to the chain, then that can be called as phenyl. We will not call benzene, then we can call phenyl. When there is an alkyl chain, see, when there is an alkyl chain, when there is a benzene, alkyl chain can act as a parent chain. Benzene comes as, or benzene we can consider this as a substituent, and it is a prefix. And in that case, benzene can be called as phenyl. Right? So phenyl ethene. What is this? Phenyl ethene. And the common name of this is called styrene. You have to remember all these things beta, because this styrene is polystyrene. There is a polymer lesson in our grade 12. Grade 12, we have 15th lesson. In the 15th lesson is polymers, and there we will learn about polystyrene. It will be useful. See, I think we have a thermocol sheet, right? Thermocol sheet is a polymer of polystyrene. It is polystyrene. It will be polymerized actually. Okay? It will be polymerized. It is called polystyrene. And what is this? No, this is allyl. What is meant by allyl benzene? I already told you. sp2 carbon will be attached to the sp3. Then we can call it as what? Allyl. So here see, alternative double bond as well as single bond. See, this is sp2 hybridization, sp2 hybridization, and this is sp3. And to this, what group it is attached? Phenyl group. At which position? Third position. Here, highest priority will be given to what? Double bond. Highest priority will be given to double bond. So, 1, 2, 3. At third position, what is there? Phenyl group. And what is the longest chain here? Prop. Prop. And at first position, what is there? E. So, 3 phenyl. Group 1 E. Did you understand? Did you understand, everyone? Did you all understand this? Yes, thank you. Yes, right. So this also called allyl benzene. Why we can call allyl benzene? Because this is allyl group. Right, see, always this can be called as allyl benzene. That means CH2, CH, and here CH2, if attached to benzene, then we can call it as allyl benzene, allylic group. See, in the next topic, we have a reactive intermediates, reaction intermediates. There we can see carbenes and all, and even we can discuss about some effects, that is mesomeric effect, inductive effect and all. There we will learn which one is like the stability of these things, carbocations and all. When we are going for the, when we are discussing that topic, we will definitely discuss about this allyl benzene and groups, right? And all things will be there. One by one we will learn over there. So that is the reason we need to learn all the common nomenclature here. That is the reason slowly we are introducing these also to you. Okay, next. What is this? Two carbons are there. So it is eth. And it is triple bond is there we have. So we have to write I. And first carbon, what exactly attached? Phenyl. So what we can write? Phenyl ethyne. Phenyl ethyne. And ethyne common name is what? Acetylene. What is that? Acetylene. What is that? Acetylene. Right? What is that? Acetylene. So this acetylene is a common name of this one. CH triple bond CH. We all know naphthalene. We know very well about it. It is what? It is what generally we will use, right? So moths, and it can act as a repellent for the moths, right? So generally we will use even in our almaras also. And it is directly sublimation compound. So what is that? When two benzenes are attached, fusing, then it is called naphthalene. And it starts from here. The memory starts from here, right? We can, if it is attached with first carbon alpha, second carbon beta, we can say beta naphthal, alpha naphthal, we can call, right? This can be helpful in our experiments. Like in our practicals, we'll see alpha naphthal, beta naphthal, and all these things we will use. Generally, we will use beta naphthal. And there is a naphthal, OL, at the end, OL is there. That means OH is present. OH functional group is present. When three benzene rings are fused together, then what we can call it as? Anthracene. What is that? Anthracene. And we have to start from 1, 2, 3, 4. And this bridged one at end, we will call that. And directly we'll go here, the numbering 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay? And here also you see, what is this? We can call it as phenanthracene. What is the difference between anthracene and inanthracene? Are you able to understand the difference? Right? This is anthracene and this is phenanthracene. All right. And this is also very, very important. Now, this is also very, very important. Right? Now, when benzene directly attached to any other group, then it is called phenyl. If there is something, see, for example, here OH is there. Generally, we can call it as phenol. We can call it as phenol. If then here, we can call it as benzyl alcohol. We can call it as benzyl alcohol. Are you able to understand what is the difference between phenyl and benzyl? Phenyl is directly attached to something. Benzene is directly attached with something, then it is called phenyl. This is also denoted with pH, right? And it is not that pH, okay? That is used for the measurement of hydronium ion concentration. That is different. And here it is benzyl. Benzyl means phenyl. Benzene group attached to CH2 and it is attached to some other group. Then we can call it as benzyl. Right? When here two hydrogens are replaced, then it is called benzol. And if three hydrogens are replaced, then we can call it as benzo. What is that? Benzo. Did you all understand? Phenyl, benzyl, benzol, benzo. One, we can, like wherever we'll have our examples, we'll see that. Right? And what is this? Toluene. What is this? Toluene. I already told you, when benzene ring is directly attached to the CH3, we can call it as toluene. Right? Now, see here. This is now considered as one group, and when it is attached to some other alkyl group, say for example, then what we can say, this can be called as toluene. This can be called as toluene, and it is attached to something alkyl group. So at alkyl groups, it is so what we can say, whatever the group here we have, it is there. So we can call orthotoluene, so and so group we can say, right? If it is attached here, we can say third or metatoluene. It is paratoluene, right? See, now we can see one example. The simple things that we have to, these are the simple things that we need to learn. Definitely we need to learn these things. When CH3 attached, what we have to call it as? Toluene. Just now we discussed. When CH3 attached, we need to call it as toluene. When OH is present, what is this? Phenol. When OH is present, phenol. When NH2 present on benzene ring, what we need to call it as? Aniline. What is that? A-N-I-L-I-N-E. Aniline. When OCH3 attached, this can be called as anisole. This can be called as anisole. When COOH is present, then what we have to call? Benzoic acid. Benzoic acid. Benzoic acid. And what is this? See here, if you understand, if you are able to understand, this is slightly different. See here, we have C double bond O and here it is CH3. So obviously, what is this? See, this is the main chain and this will be the side chain. The side chain is what? Phenyl group, no? When benzene directly attached, what we can call? This is phenyl. This can be called as phenyl. Phenyl is attached to what? Nitrogen here. Phenyl attached to nitrogen. So N-phenyl, and we can call it as acetamide. When two carbons are there, this action stand. See, we know this. CH3, C double bond O, OH. What is this, beta? Wait a minute. Yes. What is this? In 10th class already we have to learn. What is this? What is the name of this compound? Ethanoic acid, exactly. And what is the other name? What is the other name? Exactly. It is acetic acid. Acetic acid. When acetic acid, this OH is replaced by NH2, this can be called as what? This can be called as what now? Acetamide. What is that? Acetamide. So now, phenyl group is attached to what? So this whole group is acetamide. This whole group is acetamide. And to the nitrogen, who is attached here? Phenyl group. So that is the reason N-phenylacetamide. Am I clear? Yes. N-phenylacetamide. Next. This can be called as acetophenone. What is aceto? CH3, C double bond O, CH3. This can be called as actually ketone. This functional group is ketone. Generally, what we can call propanone. This can be called as propanone because prop A-N-E, E replaced by O-N-E because of ketone. So, propanone. Of this is acetone. You know acetone, right? Nail polish remover. Mostly all girls must have know about it. Decolorizing agent. And what group is present? Phenyl group is there. But as it is ketone, we will write phenone. So we can call it as acetophenone. We can call it as acetophenone. Am I clear? Am I clear to everyone? Am I clear to everyone? Alright, so this is when CH3 toluene, when OH phenol, when amine is there, aniline, when OCH3 is there, then we can call it as enizole, when COOH is present, then we can call it as benzoic acid. So with this, today I will put full stop and tomorrow we will continue the remaining things, right? And if you have any doubts, feel free to ask me. And do you have any doubts from today's class? No? Right. Thank you.